guys, welcome once again. In the last part of the flyback converter design, we have seen the circuit diagram and it's working. If you want to see that video, you can click on this card. I have also copied link in description. Right now, we are in the first step, that is selecting a core and calculating number of turns. We have already selected the core. Now, we will calculate number of turns which are to be wound around the core by calculating primary and secondary number of turns. For calculating primary number of turns, the formula is shown, where Vp is maximum input voltage, which is voltage coming to the primary side of the transformer. For primary side, we have to consider switching losses and primary resistance losses. Let's consider them as 10% of input voltage. Hence, we get Vp as 135 volts. ACP is effective area of the core, which is given by the manufacturer in the cosmofarad's catalog for E4012 core. It is 118 mm². T-on is the on time in which the transistor remains switched on, that is also decided by the designer. Here, we'll put it as 50% of the total time. Delta B is change in flux density. This value varies from 0 to 400 mTesla, and the E-core that we have selected has saturation flux density as 360 mTesla as shown in the BH curve. Now, what is the BH curve and saturation flux density? That we'll cover later on. It's not a big concern right now. But one thing that is supposed to be kept in mind is we cannot select this maximum saturation flux density for our core. If we do so, the unnecessary problems will arise. Hence, we will select the flux density at 220 mTesla to provide good working margin of the core. Hence, considering all these values, the primary number of turns will be 68. We can find out the secondary number of turns. For the secondary turns, NS equals to VST on by AE delta V. We need to calculate the secondary voltage VS, which is equal to Vout plus V losses. These losses will be of rectifier diodes, choke wiring, and transformer resistance. Let's consider these as 5 volts. Hence, NS will be 30. Generally, for 2.5 amps of current, 1 mm² cross-sectional area of the wire is sufficient. This is not the standard assumption, but if we increase this current value per mm², then more heat will dissipate and heating losses will increase. According to our design, 2 amps is the load current. The wire having 1 mm² cross-sectional area will be sufficient for us. For more details, you can see the American wire gauge chart for reference. This wire will have the diameter of 1.12 mm. Well, we'll have calculated the number of turns, but there is one more doubt whether these turns will fit into the core or not. To find it out, we need to compare the required area of the wire to be wound, which is number of turns multiplied by cross-sectional area of the wire, with effective area of the core, bobbin margin, considering it as 10% of effective area. If this value is less than the supposed value, then we can assume that wire will fit into bobbin. Hence, if we solve this equation, then we will find out that the required wire will fit into this E4012 core, and we don't need bigger core than that if we would have selected E4215 core. In that case, it would have been wastage of space. After that, we have to find out the length of the wire to be needed for winding. It is dependent on the bobbin size for one turn multiplied by number of turns. After finding all these values, we can wind the wire around core. Now, we will calculate the output capacitor such that it will meet the maximum output ripple voltage specification. The formula for selection of capacitor is shown, where T off is the off time of transistor, IDC is load current, and VPP is peak-to-peak ripple voltage. Hence, the output capacitor value is 333 microfarad. Select the standard available capacitor value and it should be greater than this, that is 390 microfarad, 200 volt. Operating voltage should be greater than maximum voltage present in the circuit. Here, it is 150 volt. Now, we will select the MOSFET suitable for our design. Typically, the flyback voltage arise at transistor is twice of the input voltage due to inductors. We will also consider 25% margin for inductive overshoot. Hence, we will select MOSFET with VDSs greater than 340 plus voltage and IDS should be also greater than twice of load current. Next, we'll select the rectifier diode. They are subjected to high, large peak and RMS current stress. So the current handling capacity of the diode should be at greater than twice of IDC. So like that, we can select all the required components for our design. Now, I'll show you a simulation of the flyback converter on PSIM. Here, all the components are connected according to topology. This is the feedback loop for stabilization of output. Now, let's start the simulation. Here, we can see the output is 55 volts, that is according to our desired output. So this was all about flyback converter design. If you have any questions, you may ask in the comment section. Hit the like button if you like this video and subscribe to my channel so that you'll see the updates about my new videos. Watch previous videos if you have any interest in all this stuff, and I'm sure you'll definitely find some interesting information from those. And finally, thanks for watching.